tissue. Let's go remove the bed sheet. Framing the battery. Now this compartment over here. It is for hard disk, RAM, and BIOS battery. Remove the Wi-Fi card. As we need to, if we need to remove the motherboard, and you will pull it by mistake. The Wi-Fi connector here will be damaged, so we need to remove the Wi-Fi cord. This is the hard disk connector. The client has taken his hard disk as is. There was some precious data in that. So, remove the connector here. Be careful with this. This is your hard disk extension connector. Remove all these screws. Here the length of the screws is written, that is, these are M22.5 into 5 mm of length. These three screws are of 5 mm length, which is written, that is, they are shorter than other screws. These two screws, that is for DVD writer, are slimmer and shorter in length, both the screws. These are different in size, keep that in mind. Don't try to force the other screws in this. Pull your DVD writer to the side. Remove these three screws here under the DVD writer. After removing all the screws, we need to remove the keyboard as well, because there are some screws below the keyboard. Lock the keyboard in this way. You can see the locks here, slots for lock. This keyboard has two cables, that is, one is for backlight. Lift it, lift the lock, pull the cable. Keyboard, remove the connectors. Remove the screws here. Removing this, you need to remove it from here. Don't try to pull it from here, you will damage it. Here you see, for removing the panel, don't try to remove from this end. Here also you can see some groove, but this is not the place to remove it. Here, don't try to remove it from here. You can see a groove here. Okay, this is not the place to remove the cabinet panel. Remove it from here, from the black and silver, where the black and silver join. Check whether any screws are pending to be removed. Here you can see one screw was there. Below the hard, inside the hard disk case slot. Remove remove the speaker connectors here. Here you see there are blocks. As you can see, the top panel comes out, not the bottom one. Sorry, the bottom panel comes out, not the keyboard side panel. See the shock resistance, shock absorber for speaker, so that the speaker doesn't vibrate. After removing the back cover, bottom case, just unscrew this. 6 screws. These screws are locked open and behind, so they won't come out totally. Pull this fan connector and power connector. Take this out. This is the heatsink and fan. Now to clean the fan totally, we need to unscrew all these 4 screws. 3 screws and 1 lock here. And here you can see the lock. Just take it out in this way. See that here you can see through the vent. And if you see it is blocked out, it is blocked. Just clean it with a brush. See, don't be too harsh, be gentle, so that you should not damage the fins ventilation. Clean the fan as well. Cleaning, fix it back. Fasten back all the 3 screws. Don't tighten them too much because they are very tiny. The threads will come out easily. Now here see that after cleaning the fan and inserting again, if you are facing any overheating problem, the heatsink compound or heatsink paste will be dried up. We need to apply new heatsink paste or compound. In my case here, it is not dried up, so there is no need to replace it or no need to clean and put it again. Before applying the new paste, you need to clean this by using isopropylene or PCB cleaner. Don't use blade or any such things. They will damage the chip. Now, fasten back the screws. This is the graphics chip. Connect the fan. Take the back cover. These are the Wi-Fi cables, antenna cables. So the Wi-Fi port. Also the screw. Connect the speaker cable here. Set all the screws now. Connect the hard disk cable. This blue part should come on the top. The connecting terminal should get. This copper pad should be on the below like this. Place it. Lock it. For hard disk and connect your hard disk here. Go on fastening all the screws. These platons, three screws will be under the DVD writer. Insert the DVD writer. Take these thinner screws. Turn your laptop upside down. There are some screws under the keyboard. We need to connect them also. Connect them in this way. Keyboard. This keyboard comes with a backlight, so there are two connectors here. So it is in this way. One, two, to connect. Lock the keyboard from all the three sides here. We are done. Hope this video has helped you. Kindly hit the like icon, share the video, subscribe to our channel if you are not yet subscribed. Thank you for watching, everyone. Have a good time.